Hey everyone, it's Lance from Cinematic Galaxy here. Today I'm going to be reviewing the 1999 animated film, The Iron Giant. Now the movie takes place in the year 1957, which those of you who know your history, the Cold War was going on during that time. And basically it starts off during a raging storm on the sea. And you see this boatman, and basically, you know, the storm's raging and he's calling for help. And he sees a lighthouse, so he starts making his way toward the lighthouse. And as he gets there, his boat crashes into it. And looking up, he sees, he basically sees what looks like a head turn to face him and look down at him with not one, but two lights. And basically, the day after, he goes around telling everybody that he saw an Iron Giant, a big Iron Giant. And nobody really believes him because he's kind of known to be a kind of drunk and whatnot, so no one really believes him. But it creates a lot of hysteria. We're also introduced to Hogarth, a 9-10-year-old boy, and his mother, who is single, and she's working at a diner, and basically she does her best raising him. And Hogarth's kind of a bit of an outcast. You know, he doesn't really fit in at school. His classmates don't really like him much because he's sort of, you know, he's a lot smarter than them. He doesn't try to be. He doesn't think he's better than anyone. I remember watching The Iron Giant on Cartoon Network back when Cartoon Network was actually good. And I was wondering why I'd never heard of it before, why I'd never seen it, but they were showing the marathon, and I remember watching that and really enjoying the movie. Though it eventually got to the point where they would show the marathon so much that I kind of got a little ticked off sometimes, because, you know, sometimes I'd turn and I'd be like, oh man, they're showing the Iron Giant marathon again. You know, because I'd want to see a lot of my favorite TV shows. It was just this past year, I think, where I actually saw the entire movie again. And I must say that I absolutely love The Iron Giant. And better yet, the story of this film is great. And one thing that I did not appreciate as a kid, that when I watched the movie, I always notice and appreciate now, is the Cold War subplot. I learned about the Cold War in 11th grade in U.S. history, where I learned about a whole bunch of stuff. And I love history. I love learning about the past and the different things that have happened in the past that make us what we are today. And the Cold War was by far one of the most fascinating things I've ever learned about. It's amazing to think all that stuff was actually really going on. And I appreciate The Iron Giant for being so meaningful in that regard. It really, in a lot of ways, is a historic piece. The characters in this film are all really good. You have Hogarth, the kid who is really likable. You know, you really root for him as a protagonist, as a hero. And he's very, you know, I'm sure a lot of kids can relate to him in certain ways. You have the Iron Giant, who's voiced by Vin Diesel, which really surprised me when I found that out. He delivers the performance of his life in this film. Same goes for Jennifer Aniston, who's Hogarth's mother. She is very good as a voice actress, and really did a great job. And Harry Connick Jr. is Dean, the beatnik, who I love in this film. He's just great. Now, the lieutenant in this film, Mansley, man, you talk about a jerk. I mean, that guy, every time he appears on the screen, you just want to punch him in the face. I mean, that guy is so annoying. But at the same time, he's hilarious. And he's a great character, too. But, gosh, you just hate him. And is it just me, or does he look like Woody from Toy Story? I don't know. That might just be me. The heart of this film is definitely the friendship that develops between Hogarth and the Iron Giant. It's so well done in this film and so believable. And it's reminiscent of other films like E.T., How to Train Your Dragon, Lilo and Stitch, all of which I love. I love those movies. But I honestly think the Iron Giant might be my favorite out of all four of these films. And, you know, it's very reminiscent. It's basically, you know, you have two outcasts who meet and become friends. You know, you have Hogarth. He doesn't fit in anywhere. He's lonely. You know, his dad isn't in his life. And then you have the giant, who's a complete outsider. And the two of them form a really great friendship. I really love the message in this film. It's so great, the message about guns and stuff. How Hogarth tells the giant that you don't have to be a gun, and you are who you choose to be. It's so applicable to real life. And I'm not getting into politics here. You know, some people, some conservatives and whatnot, might not really like this film because of how it talks about stuff like that. But I think it's a message that anyone can enjoy and anyone can get something out of. And it shouldn't ruin the movie for anyone. I don't know if I've ever actually cried at the Iron Giant. Like I've told you, I cried multiple times at The Lion King. The Iron Giant, I don't know if I've cried at the film, but it definitely brings me close to tears. Especially near the end, where the nuclear bomb is about to explode over the town and the Iron Giant goes to save it. And Hogarth always told him, you know, Hogarth introduced him to Superman. And he always told the Iron Giant, you know, you can be Superman. You're a good guy. And just hearing the Iron Giant say Superman, you know, when Hogarth told him, you are who you choose to be. And the giant decided he wanted to be Superman and be a hero and save the town from nuclear destruction. Such a touching moment, such a beautiful moment. And wow, it gives me chills every time I watch. Brad Bird directs The Iron Giant, and those of you who know Brad Bird, you know he directed The Incredibles and Ratatouille for Pixar, and he's directed Mission Impossible 4, which is coming out eventually, and he's easily one of my favorite filmmakers working today. I mean, I love Brad Bird, and he has one of my favorite quotes. I'm an aspiring animator and filmmaker, and one of my favorite quotes from him is, animation is a medium, not a genre. You know, so many people classify animation, they classify all the movies and cartoons as being like strictly for kids, or, you know, oh, it's an animated film, that means kids are gonna love it and stuff like that. And that might be true to a degree for some, but I mean, if you see so many movies like Hayao Miyazaki films and this movie, The Iron Giant, you know, they're not made for kids. You know, they're made for everybody, a wide variety of people. And, you know, I really love that. I really love that he believes that. I'm a big believer in that quote. And The Iron Giant and The Incredibles, I mean, his movies, I feel like he made the most adult movies out of all the Pixar films. And, you know, The Incredibles feels like that. And The Iron Giant, they feel like movies that were made as live action films and converted into animated films. The Iron Giant, the reason I hadn't heard of it when I saw it on Cartoon Network, it was not a box office success. It did not do well at all in theaters. And the main reason for that is it had a really bad marketing campaign. Warner Brothers did not publicize this film well enough at all. And, you know, it wasn't marketed well. And in 1999, I mean, you have films like The Matrix, Toy Story 2, Tarzan, Fight Club, which I actually haven't seen. I have to get around to that. But you had a lot of great, very popular movies. And for a movie to not get marketed well, I mean, you wouldn't stand a chance against movies like that. So that's another reason why The Iron Giant was overshadowed. Since the film has been out on video and DVD, it's gotten a sort of a cult following. And so much so that I wouldn't even call it underrated, because I feel like a lot of people love this movie. Everyone who's seen this movie loves this movie. But I would probably say it's underappreciated, because still, not enough people have seen The Iron Giant. You know, we all talk about films like The Lion King. You know, if you saw my last review, you know how I feel about The Lion King. I mean, I love The Lion King. But I feel like movies like The Iron Giant are easily of the same caliber. You know, it's easily just as great of a film. And more people need to see it. So that said, The Iron Giant is a classic. It's one of my favorite movies of all time. I'm going to give it an A+. Anyway, guys, I hope you all enjoyed this review, and if you like this review, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel, and stay tuned for more reviews that I have coming out. I should have some more good ones coming out. Anyway, guys, I hope you all have a great day, and this is Lance from Cinematic Galaxy signing off.